monster.
Threat neutralized.
Good. I have a plan to catch.
Welcome to State of Play, a look ahead to the future of PlayStation. Throughout the year, State of Play will showcase upcoming games, updates, and announcements. And we've got plenty in store for our first episode, like the debut of Marvel's Iron Man VR, which is coming to PlayStation VR in 2019 from PlayStation's worldwide studios, developer Camouflage, and Marvel Games. Up next, a fan favorite announces extra goodies for PS4 players. Let's take a look. The popular kart racer is due out June 21st. Now, let's shift gears. Next up, the team at Hello Games beams us an update from the world of No Man's Sky. It's a match made in heaven. This summer, Hello Games plans to release No Man's Sky Beyond, a major update that adds, you guessed it, PlayStation VR support. And yep, the update will be free. From PlayStation's worldwide studios. Now let's get the world's first look at an upcoming game from PlayStation's worldwide studios and developer Robot Entertainment. You're seeing first gameplay of Ready Set Heroes. This is a fast-paced multiplayer dungeon crawler that packs a big twist. Choose from multiple playable characters, then launch into a randomly chosen dungeon to slay monsters, dodge traps, and collect mountains of loot. Now, here's the twist. You're actually competing against an opposing team who's racing through an identical dungeon. Reaching the end of the dungeon will trigger a winner-take-all arena brawl. The faster you progress through the dungeon, the more powerful you'll be when it's time to throw down. Ready Set Heroes had us hooked from the moment we picked up the controller. The combat feels crunchy and the loot flows like water. The final game is expected to support up to 4 players across online multiplayer and local split screen. Sounds like perfect party game material. Look for Ready Set Heroes to hit PS4 later this year.
Yeah, so this is basically a Nintendo Direct.
Let's get an update on the eagerly awaited PlayStation VR game first announced at Paris Games Week.
Ryan Marks. SAS Nomad Squadron. You're facing multiple life sentences. Conspiracy.
Harry Jewel.
Arson. More murders than
Harry
we
can count. Harry Jewel. I'm trying to say it in French. Une Francais parlez.
I just want to know what went
down. Je parle français.
My name is
Ryan Marks.
I'm a soldier.
Alright, I'll stop.
Now, don't get me wrong. I love my day job.
I just say I speak French.
But it's always nice to come home.
I don't speak it very well, though.
Spend some time with the family. Mum!
Oh, for God's sake, what did I tell you?
See
what if I
want
to get this game and I don't feel like playing the VR?
I'm used to that special forces stealth there, mate.
Taking the sights.
Let's get inside. Find out what it's hiding.
Catch up with some old friends.
Think of it as a merger. Apart from you. you can off back to the army.
Isn't that nice?
I think I broke a window.
Tony's been approaching some of our people.
What are you looking for here?
Clues, evidence, anything that will tell us what Tony's up to.
Got it.
We need to push back hard or we're finished.
Why are you sure about this?
Get me under me! Closer!
Average weekend, really.
PlayStation VR heavyweight Blood and Truth finally has a confirmed release date, May 28th. That's just around the corner. In fact, PlayStation VR players have a lot to get excited about this year. Here's a look at the next wave of PlayStation VR titles slated for 2019.
This is definitely the right place.
This doesn't look like a PlayStation controller. What's it? It's VR, okay. Everybody's golf. Is it just gonna be VR? So they say this is the first episode, so I'm assuming they're gonna keep doing these instead of conferences. I guess, I don't know.
Okay.
Which is fine.
That's audio, at least.
Devolver Digital.
Almost there. Almost just a sec.
What is this game?
There we go. Looking good, Sam.
Yeah, that actually looks good.
Sam, give me a system.
Wait, what is it?
Diagnostic.
From the creators of Something United.
What is going on?
I was looking right at it, and I missed it. It's quite a science fiction movie. Game. It's a game, not a movie.
What is happening? To the station.
Looks pretty good.
To the station. To us.
Captain.
And quite right, too.
I assumed that was supposed to happen. Not on the station.
Whatever happens next.
I'll stop reading that because it's probably getting annoying.
Sorry.
Wait, you play as the station, or...? Probably
It's time.
Figurative speaking.
You have to take us there. You have to take us there.
Observation. Didn't they?
Science fiction thriller Observation.
I thought that already came out.
PS4, and it's bringing some serious development talent to its unusual and haunting premise. Our next game is a frightening new installment in a fan favorite.
I'm pretty sure
series.
I saw that on this Nintendo eShop already. Alright, but whatever. Maybe I'm thinking of something else. Speaking of horror games, I do have a horror game. A couple of them I need to play on the Switch still. I was playing through Outlast, and then I got stuck and haven't gone back to it yet. What is this? I forgot the name of the game. With the bear. Five Nights at Freddy's. I think that's the name of the game. I never played it, but... That's VR.
Here's some first
Lionscape.
Footage. You'll try to survive different levels from the original games, as well as all new nightmares.
Yes, be aware.
Has picked up some unwanted friends. To clear the infestation, apply the Fazbear Entertainment
Five Nights at Freddy's VR, Help Wanted, is the first virtual reality game in the Five Nights universe, and it's coming to PlayStation VR this spring. Next, let's get a new look at a gorgeous adventure coming soon to PS4 from PlayStation's Worldwide Studios.
Is that? I thought it was Sony Worldwide Studios. Well, it's the same thing, but maybe they changed the name? I don't know.
The game, you play as birds. I don't know. I'm just making shit up. Or you play as that kid. Then the screen buffers more.
Oh, what's this?
You're little. You know, I bet it's because I'm trying to stream a stream, maybe? I don't know. I had trouble with the Google Stadia and Nindies thing too, but... Aww.
Hello?
So they're bullies, basically. Is this gonna be one of those sad story games? That's cool. That's cool.
Whoa! You're alive? Hey, over here.
Dude, you know, since I was thinking of observation, I am gonna look on my Nintendo Switch just to see what was on the eShop, because I thought I seen that game. I could be wrong, maybe it's not out yet, but I thought it was out. Charges and something. It's 49%, so that should be fine for now.
Got it.
Yes. Is the eShop gonna work? Or, man, check later if it doesn't work. Or I can check the Nintendo website. Or Nintendo's online store or whatever. It's a little different still.
If I leave now, that darkness will just come back here. I can't let that happen.
I'm not even paying attention to this, maybe I should. Concrete Genie. Yeah, here's Observer.
Concrete Genie is a creative new adventure from developer Pixelopus.
Did it just never release on the PS4?
We can also confirm the game will feature a PlayStation VR mode. More details to come as Concrete Genie prepares for launch later this year. Up next, an update from the dangerous world of Days Gone.
You know, we never talked about it while we still wore the colors.
Oh.
All this time out in the freak show when shit like this didn't matter anymore.
So, see, here's proof. Here's Observer. It's available to purchase now on the Switch. Like, there's no release dates, and that means it already came out. Okay, so that's one of those.
Leaving everything behind.
What did you do?
Everything that matters.
I think I'm
going to
get this game. I know I cover more of Nintendo games, but once in a while I'd like to cover other platforms.
You find his stash. You bring it to me.
To me, Deke. You do that, we'll see what we can do for you.
Deke, bro.
And
bro.
I even stream, you know, I do
know
PC
what kind
games
of man
too.
He is. What he's done. He done any worse than you? Ricky? How about me?
You're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you. We have to look out for each other. That is all we've got.
You could have saved a few lives.
There was no hope, there was no time, there was no room. Okay, we'd already turned on each other by the time the hordes arrived.
Hope you're right about your old lady, Deke. You gotta ask yourself, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
Days Gone is just 1 month away, so let's take a peek at some new gameplay.
Days Gone. as responding
Days Gone
to the Dex
is set
message,
in a harsh and unforgiving world populated by roving bandits and flesh-eating freakers.
No, it's a month and one day. Wait, today's
John,
25th.
You'll upgrade your bike, scavenge weaponry, and toss Molotov cocktails.
Right now.
All in a bid to stay one step ahead of certain death. And you'll need all the firepower you can find when you face off with the game's more powerful freakers, like this Breaker. But in Days Gone, your wits might be your greatest weapon. Why take on a heavily guarded enemy encampment when you can lure in a freaker horde and let them handle the dirty work? We can't wait to see the screens and videos you share when Days Gone launches on April 26th. Before we go, let's get one more update from the gang at NetherRealm Studios.
So that's the same developer who did
Hollywood.
Uncharted Golden Abyss on the Vita. I wish they would bring that to consoles. Well, PS4 at least. I don't think it would come to other systems.
Go back to the 90s.
Bring it to PS4 though. So there's one more game after this, or this is the last game.
Our future, Liu Kang. It is insane.
So that's the case. It is an alright Sony Direct. I'll call it that for now on. But, you know, it's fine. But I didn't really expect there to be much shown off. Not even The Last of Us Part 2. They didn't even show that off.
This is seriously messed up.
Hang back, kid. How about we keep this between me, myself, and I?
A lot of blood. Although Nintendo's directs also show a lot of blood at times, though.
He's gonna get us killed.
Is this Mortal Kombat? No. It looks like a Mortal Kombat 11, but no, I don't think it is. No, it's not Mortal Kombat 11. Why is... If it is Mortal Kombat 11, there is a lot of blood, but parts of it seem censored. I think this is Mortal Kombat 11, actually. I don't play enough Mortal Kombat to be able to really know, but I don't pay too much attention to it. I have played Mortal Kombat before. See? Is it just me, or does this look censored compared to the Switch version? Yeah, there's still blood in it, but...
I do my own stunts. You? I got people for that.
There's still quite a bit of blood, don't get me wrong. I mean, I really don't care. I do care. I wouldn't be talking about it, but it's really not a big deal, but, you know. It's just kind of strange, though.
It's official.
Okay, yeah,
this
is Mortal Kombat 11.
Jax,
oh, no, it's
Lau
Mortal 11
Kombat. Kang are joining the ever-growing Mortal Kombat 11 lineup. And stay tuned, NetherRealm is promising more updates before launch on April 23rd. Well, that's a wrap on our very first episode of State of Play. This was just the beginning.
Yeah, it's coming
we'll be back
next
throughout
month.
The year to share new
or
announcements,
if you live in Europe.
First look trailers, and other updates from the world of PlayStation. See you soon, and thanks for watching. First look trailers and other updates from the world of PlayStation. See you soon, and thanks for watching.
Well, I mean, it wasn't great, but it was alright, I guess. That was, I guess I was on the PlayStation Europe page.
Whoa! YouTube. Oh, jeez.
What the I can't, why isn't it letting me stop? Okay, no, that's enough. I don't care. Oh, this wasn't even the PlayStation channel. All right, I'm sorry. No, it's all right. So Mortal Kombat 11 comes out next month for PS4, Xbox One, PC, and Switch. And then if you live in Europe, the Switch version will be coming out in May. I don't know what the deal was there. Unless maybe that had to do with, like, physical editions. Because, you know, that's... Anyway. I don't know really what to say. I mean, everything, you know, it was an okay direct. Yeah, I think next time I am just going to refer to State of Play as, I'll call them State of Play, and then I'll probably put like a subtitle for Twitch and YouTube. Just calling it like hashtag Sony Direct or something, you know. I don't know. It's kind of hard to say, but this is going to be the first episode, so I'm assuming this maybe around E3 we'll get another episode instead of a press conference. Now, they could still do occasional press conferences. Like, you know, Nintendo's once in a while, I know every 2 or 3 years, they'll have some kind of conference. You know, we had back in 2014 or 15, we had the Nintendo NX presentation. And then 2017, we had the Nintendo Switch presentation. And last year, we had the press conference. It was mainly from, like, the Pokemon Company, but, I mean, that is part owned by Nintendo. And they were still talking about the Switch, too. So, you know, I think I like how Sony's doing it. You know, I guess throughout the year, they could do what Nintendo does or something similar, like, kind of spread things out. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below on your thoughts on this. Nonetheless, that's going to be it. I know this hasn't been very long. I didn't really expect it to be super long, although I didn't really expect it to be this short either, but whatever. It was an okay direct, I guess. But without further ado, I'm going to end this here, and whenever the next Sony direct is going to be, I'm hoping to stream that. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time.